Hello, beautiful people. My name is Heather Walsh, and I am one of the Tabata athletes here on the channel. Today, I want to do a super quick overview of what Tabata actually is, because we get a lot of questions on it. The first big thing is, what is Tabata, and is it high intensity interval training, or HIIT? So high intensity interval training is anything where you work at a really high capacity, and then you take a break. The break is so that you can continue to work at that super high level of work output. So for example, if I told you to run 5 miles, you could not go at a super high intensity for that entire time. But if I told you to run for 10 seconds on, and I told you to take 10 seconds in between, you could do each interval at a little bit of a higher intensity because you had that rest. With Tabata, it is traditionally 20 seconds on and 10 seconds off for a total of 4 minutes and 8 rounds. It's just a specific type of high intensity interval training. So where did Tabata come from? Tabata came from Dr. Izumi Tabata. So Dr. Izumi Tabata is a dean of a big university in the Graduate School of Sport and Health Science. He became extremely famous for this Tabata protocol, although he actually credits Olympic speed skating coach Sawa Koichi, and I'm sorry if I butchered that name, with actually pioneering the technique. He's actually from Japan, and this has expanded worldwide, and I want to tell you a little bit more about it. And this came out because we were looking for anaerobic ways to work out in a really short period of time. Anaerobic activity is just really short bursts of activity, and it essentially means that we're not using oxygen like we would in an aerobic exercise. If you want more information on that, just comment below because it's really complex, but I can dive into it if you guys would want. So we see you commenters, we see you haters in the comment section. That is not a true Tabata. That is not Tabata. We hear you. And you're right. There are literally millions of people at this point finding motivation in working out in this way. So we can vary it quite a few ways to keep people interested, keep people moving, and keep people involved in exercising, which is the main goal. So what does that mean? A true Tabata would be, say, 8 intervals on the assault bike. So an assault bike is a piece of equipment that is low skill and you can have a really high output on for those intervals. If you do 4 minutes of Tabata on the assault bike, you're gonna be roasted after. It's not easy. However, we've now adapted it to do, say, 8 different movements within the time frame, and that rest period is just to give your muscles a little bit of recovery. So although the intensity may not be quite as high, we can cover a lot more of our musculature within the body, and we get a really good workout in. If we start repeating Tabatas one after the other, we can get a 20, 30, 40 minute workout in with just those time domains, and we can hit all sorts of exercises within it. The reason that we have so many videos and so many different variations of these workouts is because there are so many ways to get this done. If you switch it up, you're more likely to stay interested, and if you do, you know, 6 different videos over the course of a week, rather than doing just the assault bike Tabata every single day, you're probably gonna stay a little bit more engaged, therefore you're gonna work out for longer, and therefore, our job is done. Tabata can be used in so many different ways, as you've probably seen on this channel. We'll likely dive deeper into this in a little bit. However, you can make Tabata your own. So if you wanted to do it in like a bodybuilding style, you could do bicep curls and tricep extensions, and you could alternate those for the 4 minutes and the 8 rounds. If you wanted to keep it closer to a true Tabata, you can do something like sprints, or you could do something like an assault bike. Regardless of what you're doing, you're getting your heart rate up, you're moving around, and this time domain can be so varied. Question, is 4 minutes enough? So this is going to depend massively on the person, obviously. Would I give a 4 minute workout to somebody that was trying to go to the CrossFit Games? Probably not. They'd probably do a little bit more than that. However, the great thing about Tabatas and all of these videos is you can kind of stack them however you want. So if you're newer to exercise, 4 minutes can be absolutely plenty, especially if you're going really hard in those work periods. If you're a bit more advanced or you want a little bit more, all you have to do is do another Tabata after. You can do a little bit of rest in between, or you could go directly into it. However, the bottom line for everybody is that something is better than nothing. So if you're thinking, I'm not gonna do it, it's just 4 minutes, like I'm just not gonna work out, 4 minutes is absolutely enough. And I want you to think about it this way. If you did a 4 minute workout every day, every single day, for the entire year, only 4 minutes, you'll have worked out for 1,460 more minutes that year than if you did nothing at all. That adds up, and it can make a really, really big difference. I hope this gave you a good idea of what Tabata is, what we're trying to do here, and if you have any other questions, please put them below. We're gonna try to make a few more of these question and answer style videos, just so you guys are all on the same page as us, and we really appreciate you watching. Bye, guys.